My name is Healani-Sonoda Pale. I'm with Protest Na'i Aupuni. I'm from Kuli'o'o. My family hails from Kahana Valley on Oahu. I am a Kanaka Maoli, born and raised here on Oahu. 2 years ago, the Office of Hawaiian Affairs CEO Kamana'o Pono Krabs May 5th, 2014 letter to the Secretary of State, John Kerry. In it, he questioned the legitimacy of U.S. jurisdiction in Hawaii and requested proof of how the Hawaiian Kingdom was legally annexed to the United States. Rather than answer that question and prove once and for all that the U.S. legally annexed Hawaii, President Obama hastily ordered that the DOI hold public hearings in Hawaii to discuss federal recognition. Within 2 months of Crabb's letter, hearings on five islands went on for 2 weeks. Thousands of Hawaiians came out, but only hundreds were able to testify. Can you hold this mic?
Sure.
95% of Hawaiians who spoke out were opposed to any notion of federal recognition or state and federal interference in our right to self-determination. Since then, Obama and his DOI has been inventing processes and manipulating data to create the illusion that the Hawaiian people want a tribe. And OHA, a state agency that has spent tens of millions of dollars trying to force federal recognition down our throats, has spent even more money with their fake lists. Kana'i Olovalu, their fake Na'i Aupuni elections, and their fake Na'i Aupuni Aha 2016 constitution. Today, President Obama and the Democratic Party's Hawaii delegation in D.C. announced they now have a process. But all they are really doing is covering up the crime of the illegal U.S. overthrow of the Hawaiian Kingdom's government in 1893, something they admitted to in 1993 with the Apology Bill and Public Law 103-150. Today, President Obama furthered the crime of fake annexation and the crime of fake statehood. Today, President Obama circumvented the legal processes that the U.S. Congress is there for so that he could personally sign an executive order and give fake recognition to federally chosen Hawaiians who do not represent the Hawaiian people. Why? So that he and whoever his successor is can create a counterfeit settlement for the crown and government lands of the Hawaiian Kingdom, the so-called ceded lands. Today, President Obama spat in the face of every Hawaiian, from Queen Liliuokalani down to us Hawaiians here standing now. The only Hawaiians this new federal lie will benefit are the ones who will make money off of it. There is nothing, and there never was anything in it for the Hawaiians who suffer from the poverty invented by the U.S. occupation. Our people remain the most impoverished, with the highest rates of homelessness, incarceration, diabetes, cancer, and suicide, and on and on. President Obama doesn't give a damn about us and our homeland, which has turned into the largest military command on earth, our Aina, which has been turned into the largest concentration of open-field GMO test sites on earth, our Aina, which is constantly being desecrated and destroyed by U.S. policies and corporations. When we Hawaiians look at what is being done to us from the U.S. government and corporations, all we see is total erasure and removal of us, total exploitation and theft of who we are and what belongs to us. We are being devoured by resort lifestyles and the military takeover of our housing, so we can't even afford to pay rent in our own homeland. We are supposed to allow the ongoing desecration of what is most sacred to us. Places like Mauna Kea for the TMT project, and places like Waialeale so that corporations can bottle our water and sell it. Rather than let us use our water to grow our food, we are being forced to accept that 90% of everything we eat is shipped in from 2,500 miles away. This is unacceptable. We as a people cannot allow the United States and its greedy corporations and its bought-off sellout Hawaiians to get away with this. If we allow this to go on, our children and their children will pay the price. I want to say mahalo, everyone, for coming. I know there are some other people here that want to speak. Anybody? Okay, Leon.
Mahalo, mahalo.
Aloha. 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 I am here today to speak on behalf of the Coalition of Hawaiian Nationals, as well as the Hawaiian Kingdom. And just to remind President Obama that the Hawaiian Kingdom still exists and is still healthy and is actually coming back strong, as you see right here. And so therefore, the whole idea of federal recognition is really a joke, because there is nothing to recognize except to recognize the relationship and the nation that is already here, the Hawaiian Kingdom. So the only kind of federal recognition we will accept is that of the recognition of us as the Hawaiian Kingdom as a sovereign, independent nation. So mahalo nui. And one other thing is that this act of President Obama is just one in a long chain, the last 16 years of attempts to herd the Hawaiian people into an Indian tribe. And actually, that has failed over 16 years. There are many, many attempts, beginning with the Akaka Bill. This last thing is really an act of desperation. I see it not as necessarily as a tragedy, but as one of a plan that has gone awry on the part of the United States, and that they are actually desperate to try something. And so now they're going to the president to issue a presidential executive order. And this is really a last desperate attempt, which means the Hawaiian Kingdom is on its way back and is winning. Mahalo.
Yo, that's it. That's it.
Aloha makai. I'm Williamson Chang. I've been a law professor at the University of Hawaii for 40 years. I'm a Kanaka Maoli with roots in Kauai and Kaimuki. What I want to say is that we are not going to be defeated. There have been many, many deceits. There have been many, many coercions. There have been bayonet constitutions. This is the second bayonet constitution. We survived the first. We will survive the second. Because this is so wrong. It is so against the truth. And the truth is, at the annexation, we have discovered this in 2014, which led to the letter by Dr. Crabb, that the United States, by its own laws in this very book, the laws of the states of Hawaii, has admitted that it has never taken Hawaii. In the Organic Act, it is stated, and again in the Statehood Act. And in the Statehood Act, there was a plebiscite, June 27th, in which the people were asked two questions. One was, do you want statehood? And the second question was, do you agree to an empty state? In other words, they were fooled, they were deceived. We have been deceived for 100 years. They have never taken these lands. What they have taken is our minds. Our minds have been placed in concentration camps, like concentration camps all around the world. We are going to prevail because that is our destiny. We would be long gone by now if it wasn't. These lands are free and these lands are sovereign. We will defend them.
Our country.
So what I say to you is, this is not the end at all. They can do whatever they want, because maybe they have the power. They have shown the power in Libya, Afghanistan, Iraq. And now, again, in the place they began, in Hawaii. But it shall end in Hawaii, because we have a destiny set by Keakua and by these lands.
By the God's going to rebuke them.
Thank you very much.
God's going to hold all accountable to the fornication of our country.
Aloha. You must remember that this is an official protest of the Kingdom of Hawaii to the United States under the fact that a congressional record of May 4th, 1866 proves there is no federal land. The United States knows that a joint resolution of two papers is not a treaty. What country in the world can take a domestic law and take the sovereign dominion of a sovereign country, the Kingdom of Hawaii. There is none in the entire world. A joint resolution is a domestic law confined to the boundaries of the United States. That is evidenced under the Admissions Act, Section 2. There's no Oahu. No Oahu is in the state of Hawaii. No meets and bounds. The meets and bounds of our kingdom was established by Kauikeaouli, King Kamehameha III, under the 1840 Constitution. He sent his governor to Bern, Switzerland, that not only established our meets and bounds, but claimed them. It's in Bern, Switzerland. Also in Bern, Switzerland, we're listed as Hawaii Kopai Aina people.
Right.
We're not an Indian tribe. You have to go to the primi facie evidence. By making us under federal recognition an Indian tribe, you have genocided us under the Nuremberg Charter of Article 46, Section 8 of J of 1946, and under the 1949 Fourth Geneva Convention, Article 147. You cannot make and replace our Ko Hawaii Pai Aina people to an Indian tribe. This is total heva and genocide under international law. You cannot change our race. This is all laws. International law respects this. What is going on? Our people need to know the truth. And I want you to know this is a sovereign there. Well, how can you, even in their laws that have no subject matter jurisdiction, in the 1920 Hawaiian Homelands Act, how can they, the trustees, the debtor, tax us, the beneficiary? How can that be? Well, let me tell you, we're the largest money-making venture, the United States, who's been bankrupt since 1933 under Title Code 12, Chapter 2, Section 95, 95A and B, H.R. 1491, S.R. 93-549, and H.J.R. 192 of June 5th, 1933 says that they cannot collect one penny, one tax dollar from any Hawaiian. That's their law until the controller of the Treasury pays off the national debt, and they were supposed to do that, what? March 9th, 1933. We don't have to pay taxes. And for all those Americans out there, they don't have to pay federal income taxes under the Supreme Court decision of the writ of certiorari of April 29th, 2015. I had the Supreme Court cases. Listen, this fraud has gone on long enough. In Hawaii, we are the people, and we will not be silenced. This is a legal protest of the Kingdom of Hawaii, and these are our people, everyone here. They are all the people, and we're suffering from the depleted uranium, the white phosphorus, the Agent Orange, and all these ammunitions that they've dumped in the 20 tons of undetonated bombs from Pearl Harbor to Kiana Point. This is what the United States has left us to die for, and that's what we're doing. We're dying in Waianae. Aloha ke akua to all of you. This is a form of protest, and we are a sovereign state. And a joint resolution can never hold us.
United States and State of Hawaii needs to repent, get down on their knees and repent. And they need to, after that, they need to report themselves into the international world court of nations. Because they disrespected us, our race, our kupunas before us, and even before them, and the stolen lands, unforgivable, our currency, our monies. They're getting rich off of the skin off our backs. And it's time it stops. Repent. That's all I got to say. And International World Court wants to hear from you folks. Mahalo, malama pono. Thank you for your understanding.
Uncle Walter, can you say a few words, please?
Aloha. Well, we all knew this was coming. We were just wondering when this would happen. When I'm saying what was coming is this whole movement to make us Indians. This battle has been going on for a long time, and people have been raising monies in order to make us Indians. And those people I classify as the haves in the Hawaiian community, and the other half is the have-nots in the Hawaiian community. The have-nots are not satisfied with what is going on in their lives. They're not satisfied with what America has done to our resources. We're not satisfied with what America has done to us as people. We're sleeping on the streets. We have no fish in the ocean. We're up to here. We're fed up with this American dream. So now we know as Hawaiians that this whole system that we live under is false. We all know that there was an overthrow. We all know that there was no annexation. And we all know that this needs to be changed, that we need to push America to follow their own laws. We need to push America to follow international laws. And if we follow the laws, then we will know that we are occupied. And there are laws that allow us to be deoccupied. This is not about us being renegades or protesters. This is people who want America to follow their own laws and to follow the laws of international laws so that we can correct this havoc that we are living under.
Justice.
We need to be in control of our own islands. And this is not because we want power, this is because we care for the future generation. And we have been here long enough under this regime to know that it is a dead-end street to be under the American system. So we are here today to say to the haves that are supporting us being Indians, we are now going to be in a fight and a battle. I guess you can call it a civil war, because we are not going to lie back and accept being put further under the American system. We are not going to allow that. We want to be in a system that is based on who we are. We are a sovereign, independent, sovereign nation. That's who we are. We are an independent, sovereign nation.
And we need
to be, as Hawaiians, we need to act that way. And then once we start acting that way, then we will make this thing come true. So to all the Hawaiians, we're saying we need to start gathering right now because the war is on. People want us to become further under America, to be like Indians. So today the rules are coming down, 171 pages of rules. We cannot accept these rules. We have a sovereign nation that is trying to be put under America again. So I want to say to all of the Hawaiians, Makaala. Get up and get ready, because the people who want us to be Indians have at least $1 million that they've collected, and they're very powerful Hawaiians within this state. They're also very powerful Hawaiian in the Democratic Party, and they're going to make us Indians. That is their goal. We need to fight that. Aloha.
John Osorio, please.
Aloha.
Aloha.
So the Department of Interior has said that it has to stay out of this conversation, that this is a Hawaiian issue. The issue of a government-to-government relationship with the United States is a Hawaiian issue. That much is absolutely true. It is actually for us to make that determination. And that determination is not limited and cannot be limited in any way by a system of rules enacted by the federal government or pronounced by the Department of the Interior. It simply cannot, and we'll take this one step at a time. The United States apologized only to Hawaiian people in 1893 for the taking of our lands and the taking of our sovereignty. The United States did not apologize to the national government, to the people who are the descendants of that national government. So, in effect, the U.S. really only took a portion of the people it harmed and apologized for that. The United States now is saying, through the Department of the Interior, we are willing to only try and address one small part of the heva that we actually created in 1893. Only one small part of it. We need to be really clear with the United States. They not only do not have a right to tell us what kind of government we should have, the United States has no right whatsoever to the Hawaiian Islands. The Hawaiian Islands are the property of the Hawaiian Kingdom and the Hawaiian Kingdom government. And there is no getting around that substantial fact. You go back to the conquest by Kamehameha, you go back to the creation of the Aupuni, you go back to constitutional government, and you go back to the Mahele as well, that actually set aside and set up how all of those lands were to be regarded as property, as government property, as the property of the crown. The United States has violated all of those laws, laws that were made by a sovereign country for the benefit of its, not only of its people, but for the benefit also of people who had come to live in our country. The United States took a stable government, destabilized it, and then has the nerve today to say, we will make a deal with you. We will make a deal with you, and the deal is you agree to become our native people, and we'll negotiate some kind of settlement that will make life a little bit better for you. The very, very worst part of all of this, the very, very worst part, is that what the U.S. has done through the DOI, what the state has done through Na'i Aupuni and through Kana'i Oluwalu, those things have really actually acted to divide a people who were moving, who have been moving toward a legal, rational and reasonable solution to what to the heaven that the United States committed more than 100 years ago. We have been moving toward figuring out how to disentangle this relationship, how to rebuild our nation, and the United States and the state of Hawaii continue to interfere with this, driving a wedge between people, really reaching out to some of the Hawaiians and saying, listen, if you take this over, it becomes your problem. You'll have resources, you'll have lands, you'll have legitimacy. All you got to do is quiet down the rest of us who do not agree. And we do not agree not just because we are a ho'opa'a people, not just because we are in fact insisting on our rights. We do not agree because none of this has been good for us as a people. Not as a people, not as a nation. And we respectfully ask the United States to move out of this and the state of Hawaii to stop the continual interferences in our right to rebuild our nation. We ask this respectfully, and we are going to continue whether they do this or not. We continue to build toward the day when we will be an independent nation again. Thank you.
Mahalo, Dr. Osorio. Last speaker, Kauko Ohu, Wahilani.
Pehea oku. Maikai. Puiva. Kaumaha. Kauha. First of all, I give mahalo to Tita Healani for organizing this press conference today, and for the press for coming out. We share some facts, if you guys don't know. Do you guys due diligence, yeah? Honor, as Tita said, the U.S. gotta honor their laws. U.S. constitutional law and international law. No country can occupy another country without a treaty of annexation. Yeah. It failed twice. First of all, in 1893, when the provisional government, led by 13 Kapoya Haoles, they were Hawaiian nationals as well. It went to Washington, D.C. President Grover Cleveland stepped in and he stopped it. Why? Because it was wrong. Yeah. We were recognized in 1843 as the first non-European kingdom on the planet. We were recognized in 1843 by England and France. 1844, the United States had fallen and recognized us. So why should we need federal recognition today? Early. And that's true international law and U.S. constitutional law. No country can occupy another country without a treaty of annexation. It failed twice. Second time in 1898, it went to Congress again. And that's when Hui Aloha Aina, the Men's Patriotic League, led by James Collier, as well as Hui Kalaina, the women's patriotic league, led by Auntie Lehua, I can't think of her last name, Mahilona. Okay? They went to all the islands and then got up almost 40,000 signatures. Half of that signatures went to the Congress to stop annexation, and it did. Again, you cannot occupy a country with a joint resolution. No, listen to me. Do your due diligence. Listen to what I'm saying. That's the truth. That's the truth. So, yala, yala, nakanaka Hawaii. Yala, napoe Hawaii. Aole, aloha. Wear the love for the first people. Wear the love for the first people. We love everybody. You see these steps right here? After the overture, where the provisional government will take up this seat? In our palace. Heva, Lord.
Heva.
And now we can't even go in our own palace?
Heva.
That's besides the point, Kill. I'm getting a little bit nuha because you gotta understand my pain. I'll unplug myself from the matrix. When I wake up, see, if you guys know, I had dreadlocks for 10 years. I would hem with that bother. Because time for change. I ain't that person anymore. Time for this country. Here we go. You see everybody behind us? I see everybody over there. Let's gather together. We hold a mola hui. And if you guys, I understand, we get Kanaka out there. It's still plugged into the matrix. Yeah?
Wake up.
And I'm going to love them as well. However, you need to stand. You need to stand for your kupuna that went before you. You need to stand for your namo kupuna who come in after. Kiakua, this is the most isolated islands on the planet, on the biggest ocean, and gave our kupuna, the Ike Mekanawao, to traverse the largest ocean on the planet for come here and for thrive for a millennium before 1778 when Captain Cook came here.
No way!
Now you guys know why you feel my pain. We get truth, everybody. We get truth, Lahui. And that's what we're standing on. But we're going against a monster. One tutua. Tutua Nui. So what you gonna do with the facts? That's truth, Lahui. That's truth. Either you stand with us or you get yourself out of the way. Because no matter what, we're gonna hold a mua.
Okay, I want to thank mahalo all the speakers today and mahalo everyone for coming out today. Today is a very it's a very painful day for Native Hawaiians, for Kanaka Maoli all over the state. I know our brothers and sisters on Hawaii Island, on Maui, on Kauai are also holding press conferences today to share their manao and to say that we do not accept these DOI rules. Absolutely not. We don't accept them. So mahalo to the press for coming out, and I want to say imua na Hawaii. Aloha. Oh.